Corinthians. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 7. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 7. This is what it reads. But we have this treasure. Now, the new man that God brought into existence is called a treasure. It's precious. Not only did God take this treasure, this new man, and put him down alongside of the old, but he put him in an old building. Amen. You ain't going to carry this body to heaven. You're going to get a new body.
Amen.
But he put the new man down in that. Oh my God. But we have this treasure, listen, in earthen vessels. This is an earthen vessel. That the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. So God took this new man that he brought into existence and placed it in this old earthly body. Do you know why? So that I would have to depend upon him. That's the strategy. He's forcing me. Because if he hadn't put it in this, I wouldn't have to depend on him. I've got to depend upon him. I've got to depend upon God moment by moment.
Amen.
Not just when trouble comes. I've got to depend upon God for everything. I can mention my daughter, but I mentioned it at the house last night. When I came here, I used to pray. I used to pray this prayer. I was pastoring in West Virginia. And this was a prayer that God laid on my heart for the 12 years I was there. And I would say, Lord, teach me how to live by faith. Teach me how to walk and live by faith. Teach me how to trust you. And God brought that prayer to full fruition when I came here. I have learned to trust God.
Yes.
It's the best thing that ever happened. Because some problem you can't solve.
Amen.
It's going to take God.
Yeah.
God wants us to trust him. Amen. So he took this valuable treasure and stuck it downside this old earthly house. To force me and to force you to depend upon him. This is why Paul said, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels. Now here it comes. That the excellency of the power may be of God, watch, and not of us. God wants me and you to depend upon him. And not only that, he says, we're troubled. Are you with me?
Yes.
He says, we're troubled on every side. He's allowing this down here. He's allowing this for a reason. We're troubled not on one side, but every side. But yet not distressed. Why? Why I'm not distressed? Because God has so ordained that I have to continue to depend upon him. Not just in the good time, but in the bad time, at all times. I have got to depend upon God so I don't go around with my head down in the sand. That doesn't bring no glory to my God. I ask some people, why don't you come to church? Oh, I'm just too down. Somebody need to take you to a cliff and push you over. Don't tell nobody I said that. But you know these same people can make you work.
Yes.
Isn't that strange? It's so strange we can get up and go to that job. But we can't come to the house of God and worship Him. Amen. And God has been good to us.
Yes.
God ought to be, has been good to us. And we need to make our way to the house of God.
Yes.
And worship Him.
Yes.
God told us not to fail to assemble ourselves together.
Yes.
I didn't say it. God said
yes.
It. We need each other. God has so compacted the body of Christ. We need each other. I need you.
Yes.
And you need me.
Yes.
I need your encouragement and time.
Yes.
And you need mine.
Yes.
That's the way God has designed this thing.
Yes.
I had to throw that in.
Yes.
None of that stuff is in my notes. Amen.
Yes.
We're troubled on every side. But we're not distressed. What is prayer? Prayer is depending upon God. That's now I'm getting why God took this treasure and put it in this. He wants me to depend upon Him. And prayer is nothing but depending upon God. Jesus said in Matthew 6 and 32, your Father knoweth what you have need of all these things. So prayer is not to inform God. Mm-mm, He knows. He knows I've got bills to pay. But He has ordained that I got to get out on my knees and depend upon Him so He can bring these things into manifestation. Prayer is a powerful weapon. It's one of the most powerful weapons that you have. It's like a ballistic missile. You can shoot it anywhere.
Yes.
You can work and pray here and get action over in China.
Amen.
God wants me and He wants you to depend upon Him.
Yes.
And you ain't going to make it. That's good. That's good. I'm splitting up a verb, Chrissy. But you ain't going to make it unless you depend upon my God.
Amen.
That's why He did all this. Let me go a little further. We are perplexed, Paul said, but not in despair. Why? Because we're in Christ and we're more than conquerors through Him. You're supposed to be a super conqueror. There's not a demon in hell that can defeat you.
Amen.
There's not a demon in hell that can defeat you.
Amen.
You can do all that God wants you to do upon this earth.
Amen.
You can say all that God wants you to say upon this earth.
Amen.
Yes. I have to be careful what I say up here, but I've talked to a lot of people, and I was talking to someone, and they said, I'm afraid to say it because it'll cause trouble. I said, your battle is not with people, it's with flesh, with beings without bodies.
Amen.
You're not battling people. You're battling with beings without bodies. Let me come on and let me just skip. He's put this treasure in an earthen vessel. So He's forcing me, I know now, to depend on Him. I have to depend upon God, and you do too.
Amen.
You're not going to make it. You're not going to triumph. But if you triumph, God's going to be glorified. Because you're going to depend on Him. That's why God let these troubles come. So He gives Him an opportunity to strut His stuff in our lives. God wants to strut His stuff. God is invisible. God is invisible. But He wants to become visible. He's invisible, but He wants to become visible. And the way He becomes visible, by using my life as a stage in your life. And when the curtain goes up, and you trust God, God can put on a show. He can put on a show that Broadway can never put on. Right through your life. And some of you, the curtain is up. God wants to put on a show through your life. I see there's a thing over there in New York. They call it the Lion's King. I don't know anything about the lion. I see people just be dancing. My wife has gone to heaven, so I don't have to go to that no more. But when God puts on the show, he's invisible. But he wants to become visible. He's invisible. And the only way he can become visible is through me. And when the curtain goes up, that's why you have trouble. He steps out on the stage. And he can put on a show. He can get people's attention. Because power is manifested. Power is manifested. And that's the thing that will get the world's attention. When power is flowing through us. Hallelujah. 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 Let me close with this thought. And this is my fourth lesson. You're a new creation. If you trust in Jesus, you are a brand new creation. Something has been brought into existence inside of you that never, never existed before. And you're complete in Christ. You're perfect. Nothing can be added to you. You're perfect as now. As you be 10 billion years from now, you're going to get a new body and a new mansion. That's all. You're going to learn some new things over here. Now, here's the most important point in this whole new creation lesson. Get this. I plead with you, believe it this week. Believe this, what I'm getting ready to tell you. That is this. You must see yourself. Because you got this new creation. You must see yourself the way God sees you.
Amen.
You must see yourself the way God sees you. How does God see you? He sees you as in Christ. You are in Christ. Ephesians 5, and you can take time and begin to read it sometime, beginning at verse 21 and go all the way down. He talks about the mythical body of Christ. And he even talks about you being bone of his bone and flesh of his flesh. Christ has a body. The head is up yonder. And you are bone of his bone, Paul said. And flesh of his flesh. So God sees you. Are you with me?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
God sees you as being in Christ. He sees you as being in Christ. You are united to the body, the mythical body. Everybody that goes to church is not united to the mythical body of Christ. Some people that have never, the new you has not come into existence. But those of us who have been born again, we belong to what Paul calls there in Ephesians, the mythical body of Christ. We're connected, united to his bones and his flesh. I'm taking the time. I wanted to say. So you must see yourself the way God sees you. You must see yourself. You see, way back in eternity, God looked down through the corridors of eternity and he saw you in Christ as a believer.
Amen.
Predestination is never connected to sinners. Never. It's always connected to believers. He saw you as being chosen and in Christ. He saw you as Romans 8 and 29, way back in eternity, being conformed to the image of his son. He was looking down eternity and saw all these things. Are you with me? When Jesus Christ started up the Calvary, you must see yourself as in Christ. Because my Bible teaches that when they nailed him to that cross, and oh, it was so cruel. They nailed him to the cross, they nailed you to that cross.
Amen.
That's why Romans 6 and verse 6 said that your old man, it's in the Bible. It's in the Bible. You got to see yourself the way God sees you. When they hung him up there, they took nails and they pounded them in his hands. And then they